Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to Finance Tube. Your friend Vishal Thakkar back again with an interesting debate. Oil versus gold. Now, many a times, a lot of people, when they travel in the train, in bus, or when they meet each other in the flight, there is a constant debate going on. What is happening to the oil price? What is happening to the gold price? How is oil related to gold? Now, this video is dedicated only to make you understand the fundamental economics of how oil functions, how gold functions, and what is the relationship between these two commodities. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, first things first, we need to understand that both oil and gold in its economic fundamental level are commodities. Now, you create oil futures, oil options, gold futures, gold options, paper gold, exchange traded gold, commodity exchange, blah, 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 is all possible, is all best way to complicate simple things. But at a very simple level, let's talk about oil first, okay? What is oil? Oil is something which you drill and you find below the surface of the earth. It's a fossil fuel. It is available to us in the crude form. We have refineries in Singapore, in India. Indian refinery is quite efficient. It even beats the Singapore benchmark owned by Reliance. We have all many other refineries as well. What they do is they take this crude oil, they put it into a big tube, and at different temperatures, your petrol, diesel, naphtha, ATF, etc. comes out. Now, the whole idea is that the entire transportation system, heating system in the world is dependent on oil. Why? Because that is a source of energy for us. But however, as you know, with the recent convention in France, we are all committed to renewable energy, and people are predicting that the dependency on the oil will go down in next 10 years. Having said that, friends, that's why we are seeing there is so much of fluctuation in the oil price. Now, we'll not debate the international geopolitics as to why, who is doing what, and how it is affecting the oil price. We need to understand the fundamental relationship between oil and gold. So, let me go to gold now. What is gold? Gold is a precious commodity. It's a metal which is rarely found on this earth. The uses of gold, most of the time, gold is used for making jewelry, which women wear, men also wear. Depends on different customs, religious, and other factors. However, gold is mostly ornamental. Some of the gold is consumed with food. They gold plate the food and then you eat gold. Yes, you do, at a very, very minor or a small level. All other gold is considered as store of value. Gold is suddenly important because till 1971, we had something called as Bretton Woods system. So from 1945 to 1971, all the currencies which were there, they were backed up either by gold or by dollars. In 1971, when President Richard Nixon unilaterally walked away from the gold standard, where he said that I no longer will back every currency with a dollar, all the currencies became fiat currencies. So today, all the currencies which are printed around the world, they are nothing but paper notes. They have no backing. So if you have an Indian currency or Saudi currency or even US currency for that matter, and if you go back to the Reserve Bank of United States and say, hey, take this dollar and give me gold, they may not be able to give you all the gold. Or at least, they will not be able to give you complete gold for the amount of dollars that you are handing over to them. Now, this is true not just for US, but for all currencies across the world, including China and India. So what happens is that Indian RBI, let's say, keeps a minimum reserve of gold, and then all the other backing up is backed up by either dollar or a basket of currencies. In our case, we have a soft peg against dollars, so most of our reserves are in dollars, and we have some amount of gold which is kept with us as reserve currency. Now, why is gold a reserve currency? Gold is a reserve currency because A, gold is metal. B, gold is considered as store of value. That means the currency may fluctuate. The value of rupee dollar goes up down, yuan dollar goes up down, yen dollar goes up down, and so on. You know, it keeps on happening. But the value of gold in every currency is maintained. Why? Because gold is the store of value. Now coming to gold and oil. So please understand, in most simple terms, gold and oil have positive correlation. If oil goes up, gold will also go up, and vice versa. Why? Simply because gold is a natural hedge against oil. Or let me put it this way, gold is a natural hedge against oil price. So what happens is that if you feel that oil is too volatile or you cannot trust oil for putting your money, you can always go back to gold, because gold, even if it may fluctuate along with oil, but you will not lose the value of your currency. Because otherwise what will happen is that if you have, let's say, $100 in your pocket or 100 rupees in your pocket, the amount of oil with which you can buy with that 100 rupees will vary, whether you are buying it today or 2 months from now or 2 months behind in time. Same is the case if you have 100 rupees today, the amount of gold which you can buy today or maybe 2 months later or 2 months prior would differ. But once you have gold, the amount of oil that you will buy with, let's say, 100 grams of gold will be pretty much standard. Or vice versa, if you have 1 barrel of oil and the amount of gold that you will be able to buy from that 1 barrel of oil would be pretty much constant. So, to end the debate, the conclusion is that oil and gold go hand in hand. Higher the oil, higher will be the gold. And lower the oil, lower will be the gold. So basically, gold follows oil in its strict economic sense. However, this topic can be still be open to debate from various other perspectives. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for listening to me and watching this video. If you have still not subscribed our channel, please subscribe now. Our channel, Finance Tube. This topic of discussion is balance sheet. A lot of people ask me, what is balance sheet? How does it work? Why do we have to prepare balance sheet? And stuff like that. Current assets are assets which keep on churning all the time. So your inventory, your receivable, your cash, etc.